Hello, everyone, and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you're visiting for the first time, thank you so much for checking this out. If you're returning, thank you as well. The other day, I was scrolling through the Apple Music on my phone, and I saw this graphic pop up. It caught my attention. It looked really neat, and I thought, I wonder if I can make this in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and try it out. Here I am at express.adobe.com, and I'll start by creating a custom size graphic. I'll use the default here, which is the square. Let me import the graphic that I will be recreating here in Adobe Express, which is this one right here. And so let's go ahead and take a quick glance at it. So we have a background, and then we have an overlay, and then there's like a shadow effect underneath that overlay. So that's what we're going to recreate. Let me go ahead and just move it out of the way here for a second. And I'm going to add a shape of that runner, and let's see what we have here in shapes. So I'm trying to find something close to it, something that'll mimic what we have there. Let's go ahead and go with this one right here. So we've got that runner. So the first step that I'm going to do is create that cutout. So what I'll need to do, and what I'll go ahead and do, is get rid of that. Actually, what I'll do is create a duplicate page. So we have the original project here. Let's go ahead and move that here. So we've got that as a reference, and we'll go ahead and delete that reference here. And what I'll do is I will choose a solid color here for the background. So I'll go with that, maybe that reddish, maybe a little darker. There we go, right about there. And I'm going to change the color of the running man here. You know, reference to a movie there. And I'll leave it at that. And we'll go ahead and download this to the computer. Next, I'm going to duplicate this project here. I'll go ahead and duplicate. Let's come back to the original one here. And I'll go ahead and delete this here. And then I'll go ahead now and upload that graphic that I just downloaded. So we'll go to Photos and choose Upload, and we're going to bring that in. And you might be wondering, Claudio, why are you doing that? I'm going to show you right here in just a second. And let's go ahead, just to show you really quick, let me remove that background color here. Let's just go with a gray. So you'll see this is the actual background. This is the graphic. So we're going to bring that and just kind of center it right here on the project. You'll see the hash marks. There we go. And what we'll do now is we'll choose Remove Background. And what will happen is it will remove that reddish color. But what I want to do here, this is a little trick. It's called Invert Cutout. And what it will do is cut out the running man there, make it transparent, and keep that red. So we're going to choose that. And we should see that gray bleed through. Perfect. So now what we'll do is, let's just move this to the side, is we're going to take this background color and we are going to add an image. So let's go ahead and go with choose image, and let's kind of think of something grungy. Let's go ahead and maybe choose, let's just go with art here for a second and see what comes up. Maybe we have some cool texture. Let's see. This looks actually pretty cool right here. Let's try this out and see what that looks like. Yeah, pretty good. It's added to the background. I kind of like that. And because it's an entire image, we can actually move that around. So yeah, let's go with that. And let's put it about right there. So let's see what that looks like. We'll bring this here, see what that looks like. Pretty cool. All right, so now the next step, what we'll do is, let's adjust this a little bit, make this just a tad bit bigger so we can see. So the next step is to duplicate this top layer, and we'll go right here and choose duplicate. So we'll actually have two of those versions. So you have that one and that one. And so we'll go ahead and select all. I just use Command A. We want to align everything up so everything is matching, and then we can center it. There we go. And what I'm going to do is choose the underlying layer. This is important. You don't want to choose a top layer. Choose the underlying layer. And what we're going to do is twofold. We're going to filter that. We're going to go to filter here. And you'll notice it changes color. And what we'll do is you can do either grayscale or click on duotone, and we're going to choose black. We want this to be entirely black. So let's go ahead and move that up a bit. Here we go. We will choose more. We'll go with black and make sure we'll do the same with the other duotone color just to make sure. So we have an entire black filter on that layer. And now the next step is we're going to choose blur. And you already see a little bit of that effect underneath. And so what we'll do here is we will create a bit of a blur. And with that underlying layer selected right here, we're going to make that just a tad bit smaller. So you can see that layer right there. Let's bring that blur down to like a 3. We want just a little bit more sharper. And then with my arrow keys, I am adjusting that shadow underneath. Maybe go a tad bit bigger or smaller. So this is kind of play by trial and error here. And I'm just trying to adjust it so it's closely to the original. So let's go to the original here. There is the original. And so let's come back to my version. And that is pretty good. Not bad. And that's how you can create the cutout shadow effect in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks so much for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another. Peace.